Hi, this is Eric J coming at you with street news. No, we ain't professional and neither is this story. 19-year-old Anisha have been charged with attempted second-degree murder after she tried to shoot a man for not giving her oral sex. So look, according to the reports, the unidentified man said, "Me and Anisha spent the whole day together. We was just getting to know each other. We went out to eat. Everything was going good. So I asked her, 'Do you want to go back to my apartment and hang out?' And she said, 'Yeah.' And that's when everything went downhill. She went from asking me to give her oral sex to demanding that I give her oral sex. And when I refused, she pulled out a 40 caliber pistol and pointed it at me and told me if I didn't, she was gonna shoot me. I don't know how I did it, but I grabbed her by her wrist to get the gun out of my face and I ran out of the apartment. I didn't have time to take the stairs, so I jumped off the second floor balcony." Police said Anisha fired one shot in the apartment and she fired more shots in the direction of the man as he ran away. While being arrested, she resisted the officers and had to be taken to the ground. She also stole a shotgun and a PlayStation 4 out of the man's house while he was running away.
This morning, a woman will face multiple charges after she attempted to shoot her date for refusing to give her oral sex. This is 19-year-old Anisha Speed. Police say Speed was at the victim's apartment in Baton Rouge when she asked him to perform oral sex for her. When he said no, she allegedly aimed a gun at him and threatened to shoot. The victim then jumped out of a second floor balcony as she was firing. The officers found Speed outside of the apartment. She was taken to the ground and taken into custody.
Listen, I remember when I first got my apartment, I couldn't wait to invite people over. Like, yeah, I live in Sherwood. I'm right there off of Corsi Boulevard. I stay in them apartments right there by the Circle K. Come holler at me. That was my attitude until I met this female. And this female made me feel uncomfortable. I remember one night I told her, "I don't want no company tonight, because I gotta get up early and go to work." And I clearly remember her saying to me, "I didn't ask you if you wanted company or not. I told you I was coming over." And the way that she said it, I knew she was serious. And before I could say anything else, she said, "What you gonna do? You gonna call the police on me if I show up? Look out the window. I'm already here. I'm standing next to the playground." And in that very moment, I said to myself, "Eric, never again." And I thank God I stopped when I did, because I don't know what I would have done if I would have ran into Anisha. The man said she asked me to go down on her, and I told her no. Next thing I know, she pulling out a 40 caliber pistol, putting it in my face. "You could go down on me in this bed, or I could shoot you in your face and put you under the ground. Whatever you want to do is up to you." And she actually tried to kill him. Listen, I could think of a few things that would cause somebody to take somebody's life, but this ain't it. No man should have to jump off the second floor of a building because somebody's shooting at him because he don't want to go down on them. Listen, these are the type of situations you see in prison. Follow me to the shower or get stabbed right here. Anisha, listen, this is not how we behave out here. No means no. You can't force somebody to go down on you. Just find somebody else. There's somebody for everybody. Listen to me. If you just look a little bit friendlier and put a smile on your face just a little bit, Anisha, I could promise you, you'll find exactly what you're looking for out here.